Okay, guys, welcome back for the fourth episode of Your Questions Answered. Today we have JohnnyBelo here from YouTube, and he asked me, he saw my YouTube tutorial explaining how to do lightning bolts in Photoshop, and he then asked me if there was a way to remove the black background from that lightning bolt. And I said, well, yeah, there is, but I haven't done that tutorial really recently, and there wasn't HD at the time, so I told him I would redo the tutorial recording and put it in HD format. I believe at the time I did that, I was actually recording the screen with my video camera as well, so that didn't turn out too well. It was hard to see what I was doing. So here we go, guys. We're going to take round two of this. We're going to open up Adobe Photoshop CS3 real quick, and we're going to start a new project by hitting Control N on the keyboard. We're going to set this as a web preset at the size of 1024 by 768. And in this case, we're going to name this lightning. Number two, because we have to take two, of course. We're going to set the resolution to 72 pixels per inch, and we're going to use 8-bit color mode on red, green, blue. We're going to use a transparent background in this case as well. We'll click OK, and it'll open up our painting surface, which we can expand a little bit. And there we have it. So we have to actually fill this in with black. So we're going to hit X on the keyboard, making sure that we have these set to default. X on the keyboard is going to swap these two color palettes around. And at that point, we can hit Control Delete on the keyboard as well, and that'll fill everything in black. Now, we want to create a gradient on top of this. We can simply do that by clicking and dragging using our gradient tool here. You do want to make sure you have a linear gradient using the foreground, background colors in your selection, and make sure everything here is set correctly, same as mine here. And once you get something that looks similar to this, at least, we can then add our next effect, which is going to be a difference clouds effect. So we're going to go up to Filter, Render, Difference Clouds. And as you can see right here, we have our lightning bolt in black. If you don't like the look of it, hit Control Z or Control Z, and then hit Control F. And it'll give you a different effect every time until you get something that you seem to like better. So we're going to go with something like this. Now we have to remove all this black from around the image. So we're going to remove the white. In this case, but we have to reverse the colors first. We have to invert the image. So we're going to hit Control I, and we have our white lightning bolt. So now we want to remove the black. And we're going to do that with an image adjustment here. So we're going to go up to Image Adjust Levels. You can hit Control L on the keyboard if you really wanted to. We're going to drag this leftmost slider over towards the right. We don't want to go over too far, or else you're going to get a really thin lightning bolt, which doesn't look like anything really. So we're going to drag it out a little bit, give it a little bit of body, and we'll click OK when we have something we like. Now at this point we do have to clear up some of the colors here. We want to select our color of black once again, and we're going to go to the paintbrush tool, and we're going to clear up some of this image. If you have any white, it may mess you up a little bit later in your selection. So at this point, we have our lightning bolt. We like how it looks. We want to add a little bit of color to it. So we're going to go up to Image, Adjustment, Hue, and Saturation. We're going to check this Colorize button over here, and you're going to see it turns a maroon red. We're going to bump up the saturation, which is how deep the color is on this particular area. And we're going to bump up the hue to a color that we really like. In this case, we're going to do a blue-type color, a light blue, similar to this. When we have what we like, we can click OK. And there you have it, your finished lightning bolt. Now, how do we remove the black background? Well, there's a few ways to do this. We can use the magic wand tool and say select here and then shift click over here, and then actually invert our selection with shift control I. And at this point we would want to add a little bit of blur to our selection. So we want to go up to Select, Refine Edge, and you'll notice it previews our selection. In most cases, before you actually apply any of this, it would look something like this. So if you were to press Delete before refining your edge, this is what you would be left with. You would have all these jagged edges. So what we want to do is feather this out a little bit and it'll update in real time, probably about 1.1 pixels, and smooth it out as well a little bit. And we have something that we like. We'll go with 1.5 and 3 for the smooth. And we can also adjust the radius if we really wanted to get a different effect. And we'll click OK when we have what we like. And at this case, we can hit Shift-Control-I once again to invert our selection, and then hit Delete. That basically does cover how to remove the black background. However, there is another way of doing this. So we're going to hit Alt-Control-Z to jump back a few steps. And we have our original lightning bolt. Another way would be to use the color selection range. So we can go up to here and say select color range. And at this point we can say, hey, I want to sample the color that I want to select. And it gives you an eyedropper. We're going to click black. And then we're going to click OK. And at this point, everything that is black has been removed. Now you'll notice that some of these little areas here haven't been selected. That's simply because maybe we had a little bit of color there that wasn't pure black. We can simply select our marquee selection tool here and shift click around these and add them to the selection. There'll be an additive select. And at this point, we can invert our selection once again, refine our edge once again. It'll remember our presets. However, we may want to make a few adjustments at this point. Can click OK, invert our selection once again with Shift Control I, and at this point we can hit delete. And once again, there you have it. So whichever way you want to select the black, you can do that. In more complex settings, like if you wanted to remove the background from a hammock which had all of those little spaces in it, you would want to use the select color range tool. In this case though, the magic wand does work quite well. So we're going to hit Control D to deselect. And there you have that, Johnny. You have a removed black background from the lightning bolt. And in this case, you can use your move tool to move this around. You can hit Control T to transform this, make it really, really small, or make it huge. You can duplicate it. Once again, you can use the layer modes and set them as a screen. In this case, I'm going to duplicate this layer by dragging it down. We do have to hit enter once we transform. We'll duplicate this layer by dragging it over to the new button here, if I could do that today. And it'll give us layer one copy. At this point, we can screen this through if we really wanted to. And it'll sort of blend with the other lightning bolt, give you a different effect to go there. So that's how you do this, guys. This has been Your Questions Answered, number 4 for JohnnyBelo here on YouTube. I'm Dave from Sonic Garb Studios. Stay tuned for future videos, and thanks for watching.